A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for Sunday, 23rd June, on the front page you have time running out to curb terror, Pakistan told. So New Delhi has stated or mentioned the FATF, Financial Action Task Force, move to blacklist Islamabad. So FATF, we have seen how it has not yet blacklisted, but it has warned Pakistan that it might be getting blacklisted. You should know the countries which are in the grey list. Pakistan presently is in the grey list. So this is the detail given here, you can see. So 12 countries including Ethiopia, Sri Lanka, Yemen are on the grey list with strategic deficiencies in two aspects, because Financial Action Task Force looks into two aspects, money laundering and terror financing. So blacklist means if Pakistan is failing to take action on this 27-point checklist by September 2019, then it may get into blacklist too. So blacklisted countries presently are Iran and North Korea under FATF. And blacklist will mean severe strictures on Pakistan's banks and credit rating, as well as access to loans and foreign investments. Then here you have Indian Airlines told to skip Iran's airspace. So Director General of Civil Aviation, the Civil Aviation Regulatory Body in India, has decided to ban Indian carriers from flying over Iranian airspace because the hostilities between US and Iran are increasing. We see allegations and counter allegations are there on ships here being targeted, plus also US drone was brought down by Iran. So this is a decision taken in India to ensure the safety of passengers, crew and the aircraft flying through that route. Then on page 7 you have AES prevention, acute encephalitis syndrome prevention, Orisha shows the way. So no deaths due to the disease have been reported here in Malkangiri since 2017. So Bihar is struggling because of the outbreak of AES, but in Orisha there have been no such cases because it has learnt its lesson following the AES deaths in Malkangiri in 2016. So timely precautionary measures have been taken by the state government of Orisha. It has ensured no child has died due to Japanese encephalitis and acute encephalitis syndrome since 2017. So the vaccination is a major weapon against AES2, which has been undertaken, you can see. So vaccination against this has been included in the immunization program for children throughout Odisha. And a major preventive measure against AES which has been taken is regularly clearing the bushes of Cassia accidentalis plants, and they are motivating tribals to not let their children eat beans of the plants. So AES generally has an outbreak in AES prone regions ahead of the monsoon season. So they take precautionary measures, vaccination drive has been in place. ASHA workers, Anganwadi workers have been provided with special kits to administer medication in case of emergency. Then on page 11 you have skeletons found close to Bihar hospital plagued by AES deaths, acute encephalitis syndrome deaths. So here you can see improperly dumped, you know, following postmortem, because it's close to the postmortem site of this Krishna Medical College Hospital in Muzaffarpur in Bihar, where AES deaths have been reported. More than 100 children have died since June 1, 2019. And here you can see human skeleton remains have been found. These are unclaimed bodies after postmortem. They are cremated in due course. So it says these skeletal remains are found in the spots where cremations are set to take place. Means cremation is done in such a way that the remains are still there. It has not been properly cremated. Then this is Odisha uses satellite imagery to create unique flood hazard atlas. So it is aimed at tackling floods effectively. So the system takes into account flood inundation data from 2001 to 2018, and flood hazard atlas has been prepared. So it will help in several ways, like you know, to systematically plan flood control measures, to control developmental activities on floodplains, and also to carry out relief and rescue operations, plan relief shelters and health centers. Then on page 13 you have Kartarpur bridge work in Pakistan stalls. So now Pakistan says that there are defense concerns and it has stopped the construction work here. Initially it had agreed to the proposal to construct the corridor, the Kartarpur corridor, Deadline for completing the work is 23rd November 2019. Then on international page you have US report expresses concern on communal violence in India. So this is US Secretary of State report, which is called 2018 Report on International Freedom. So, and it's an annual submission which is made to the US Congress as mandated by law. So it talks about countries across the globe. So here it talks about India too, and it says that there are instances of communal violence in India. So it says there were reports by non-governmental organizations that government sometimes failed to act on mob attack on religious minorities, marginalized communities and critics of the government. Then below you have Palestinians reject US's West Asia peace plan. So this is West Asia peace plan of US President Donald Trump. His son-in-law Jared Kushner, he unveiled the first economic portion of this plan, West Asia peace plan, which has been rejected by Palestine. Palestine said we are not Hamas. Palestinian Hamas said Palestine isn't for sale. So what is being proposed? There are it is said there were a number of abstract promises, no political solution. One proposal, it's an economic plan, as you can see. So it one proposal was for construction of $5 billion transportation corridor to connect West Bank and Gaza. But Palestinian negotiator a veteran Palestinian negotiator said that Trump administration's stance was an entirely wrong approach. They can end the occupation, which is the most basic requirement for prosperity. He says there can be no prosperity under occupation. So this is what she says, Ms. Ashrafi. So then there's no important news on business page. And then you have on page 16, the FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions, which is a coverage every Sunday. So important coverages I heard. One is, why is the litchi toxin causing deaths? So this is regarding litchi toxin, which we have been discussing in the context of Muzaffarpur deaths because of AES, acute encephalitis syndrome. So the complete detail is provided here. This is important. We have covered this over the week, but this is detailed coverage, which it should be known. It was there in the editorials and news. This is Libra unveiled. So this is regarding Facebook's plan of having a cryptocurrency Libra. So this article talks about questions like, what is Facebook's plan to empower billions? How Libra will empower billions? What is Libra's technology? And is this cause of worry? Then this is, how will Jet's insolvency process play out? So Jet Airways has been referred to NCLT. That also we have discussed in this. So this is detailed coverage on the issue. Jet's insolvency process. It's questions which need to be answered are like, will potential buyers be interested in capitalizing on the airline's brand value and try to relaunch the carrier? Or will it be sold off? How would it work? So this is the question. And then the process is going on, and it will be, this is all speculation. But the other two articles are very, very important. Then every Sunday you have science and technology coverage. So here this is IIT Guwahati uses water repelling cotton for sustained drug release. So duration of drug release can be tuned by varying the water repelling property of cotton. So they have made this water repellency, tailored this water repellency so that drug is released in a sustained manner over several days. Then on the last page you have ASEAN vows to tackle ocean waves. So this is the regional grouping, Association of Southeast Asian Nations. So the leaders of ASEAN are expected to sign Bangkok Declaration on fighting maritime trash. So ocean waste, ocean pollution has been a major issue and has been continuously in news for so long. So now ASEAN group has also vowed to take action under its Bangkok Declaration. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com in the current affairs section, and you can download the current affairs PDFs here. Also, you can watch the complete detailed current affairs video, which has been uploaded for the last 2-3 days. So that is a sample video. The details of the current affairs course is provided here with further sample videos too. So that is it. Thank you.